whole league that he's pretty much one of the best players in the game.
Yeah.
So heading into this, I mean, what are your predictions? What do you expect to see in this matchup?
Well, for me, this is a tough one. And actually, I think I was leaning a little bit more towards Echo Fox on it. But I know Ghost preparation has been insane for this event so far. And but what I do know is that either one of these teams is going to have such a tough time against Fable. And what I will say about our winner bracket finals tomorrow, whoever wins that has the best chance at winning this event, because we know how difficult it is to win two series in Gears of War.
Yeah, and I mean, Echo Fox really come into their own the past few weeks, getting back to the old Echo Fox we've seen. But in this event, I think Ghost Gaming has the advantage here. They played, again, Fable, some more top caliber teams coming in this matchup. So they've been battle tested here, and I think they're going to give them a run for their money, baby.
They've gotten a good grade for me, I'll tell you that.
Well, so do you have any more great predictions today against Ghost Gaming?
I already made one bad one, so I'm going to go
with another bad one. What was your bad one?
I picked Motivate over Ghost.
I thought about doing that, too. I ain't going to hold you up.
No, I thought it would be a better match, and it ended up not being. But for me, I think I want to see if Echo Fox can continue the dominance that they had online. I was going 2-1 here. Going with the favorites. Going to see if they can reclaim that spot and get into the grand finals.
Yes, the game we have all been waiting for. Ghost Gaming going against Echo Fox on main stage.
The recipe for success for this event for Echo Fox is to stay consistent and stay on our toes and stop with the hesitation. We've been putting in work, and if we play how we do in practice, we're going to win the event. This is 100% the best Echo Fox you're going to see this event. We're firing all cylinders. We're going to play with pure energy, and we're going to be a lot more exciting this event. You're going to see a lot of us stand up more, talk trash, and just have fun with it. No team stands a chance against Echo Fox, so only time we lose is because of us. Now we're full throttle just going at people's necks, so we're definitely winning this event.
Very important keys to the game. Kyle said they need to stay consistent and stop their hesitation, and that's been Echo Fox's biggest problem. They've been on tiebreaker maps plenty of times against OpTic Gaming and especially Ghost, but their problem is finishing out. Waldo, what do they have to do to stay consistent and come out on top?
They've got to start taking the advantage early, and then if it starts getting late and starts slipping away from them, they've got to start slowing it down and controlling the game a little bit more. They haven't been the best on round 13s this season. Hopefully that it doesn't come down to the line.
Yeah, and again, to reiterate what Waldo's saying, play for each other, play together, play composed. We saw Rushies earlier getting into fights, normally where he would take them till his death, but able to back out certain moments there. So an improvement for him, an improvement for this Ghost team for sure.
We're about to kick this off on the final game of the day, Echo Fox against Ghost Gaming.
And it's your boy, Guy Blazing Deluxe, coming at you guys live here. We got a great one. Our semifinals, Ghost Gaming versus Echo Fox. Who's going to meet Fable in the winner's bracket finals? This is going to be a good one. We're kicking this off on Harbor.
Yeah, Harbor looking good here. We're going to see Fran get the kill on Rushy, Speedy with their turn on Toy. So a one-for-one fight still going down on top. Windshow is Fran going to try to push up here, get through those smokes. Players are rotating around 2v1. Some support fire coming for Echo Fox, but not going to be enough there as Sleepy Time does take him down. Advantage going to Ghost currently.
Yes, it is. Praise trying to win this matchup so far. Right now, you got both heels being controlled, both home heels being controlled by each team. Now, folks on Harbor, we know when you're controlling this height advantage up top on Stern, you can easily get that neutral heel at B. And Echo Fox looking to win this one. Praise got a big 1v1 versus Sleepy. He's going to get that melee off. He needs to reload his gun. He's going to get that reload in. Now, being patient, we know how Praise likes to hold those shots and connect with them. Very, very patient and deadly player he is. Now, he's pushing across, and he's looking for static.
Yeah, great job by him. I'm actually waiting for his teammates to come over and support him. Now he wants to push the pressure here onto Ribs. Going to get the pressure and going to get the chunk there. Great job by him. Again, head down now. No regard for his own life, it appears, as Praise will be putting the pressure on Ghost Gaming here on their home end.
And you know just how aggressive Praise is, but he's a methodical aggressive. Like, just the fact is that, you know, the way he takes fights is just so crazy. His movement is insane as well. And Echo Fox is going to take round number one. Now, Lux, when it comes down to this weapon placement, I'm curious to see what happens. Now, with both these teams, we're going to see some type of long-range weapon up top.
It's going to be
Torque Bolt, M-Bar, maybe Snipe, but I think Torque Bolt, M-Bar. It depends. If it's Echo Fox who's going to place it on Stern first, maybe Torque Bolt. If it's Ghost, it's going to be M-Bar. And so let's see. And actually, I think you might have hit it on the head. You called it, actually. You called it with the Torque Bolt.
Okay, there we go.
There we go. Now it's going to be locked in. But We know that when it comes down to Ghost Gaming, Speedy is one of the best torque boy players in the league. I like to call him Red Arrow at times.
I mean, not one of the best. I think he is the best, honestly.
I agree with you, especially in the league now. And it's funny, you know, I wonder if his coach has ever given him any tips with that torque boy. We know how good Fatal used to be with that back in the day as well. But all right, torque boy's up top now. I do know Echo Fox and Gillis loves this placement, so both teams can excel at it. But you want a long-range weapon like that. But the torque roll, if you hit like a wall or put it on the ground, that slash damage is going to pick up kills as well.
Yeah, Fran pushing through there, getting the first kill, but Sleepy going to shut him down right away. Echo Fox still fighting on top. Ghost Gaming, Sleepy in a nice little corner, turns a corner, gets the chunk on Toy. So we're going to see here if Speedy can pick up that torque bow and get himself in position here to make some plays for Ghost.
Yes, he is. And so Speedy's coming off a respawn. We're going to see, I don't think anybody picked up that torque bow just yet. Is still sitting up top, so not in possession of anybody. And now Solar's trying to push through his spine. He's going to be able to take down Speedy as well. You got a two-hill advantage, one in favor of Echo Fox. They're decapping A, and Rushies is able to catch Solar, so that hill will not be capped. Sleepy Time is going to be on that hill, so they will be able to get control of their home hill once again. And now Echo Fox has the advantage, but Ghost, they got up top, which is that height advantage. But Rushies, we're going to see if he can pick up any turbo kills to kind of push these guys back.
Yeah, you got to get them off Windshear. Can't let them sit there just lining up a shotgun and then go for it, but not connect there from Rushies. Now pushing up even closer. Now Torbo in his hands. Might want to put it away as the pressure being put on him by Echo Fox. Staying alive, though. Two kills for Ribs off screen. Great job by him killing Fran and Toy Soldier.
And they were both trying to overextend and get to the home hill of Ghost Gaming. So good defensive move by him. They're going to get that third kill. So the last two members of Echo Fox are going to be on top of their home hill. And Ghost does have the neutral. At this point, Echo Fox is going to say, hey, you know what? Let's chill out. Wait for everybody to respawn. Let's spread out. But Rushies has the torque bow. New bows are going to be up soon. I think Ghost Gaming just holds this two-hill setup for a little bit. Rushies going to need some help up top.
Yeah, they got the height advantage. But Echo Fox pushing in. They're going to trade kills there. Rushies trying to back out. But now wants to opt and take the fight, and for good reason, takes him down a little bit of a hump there, coming out for Ghost Gaming here on round number two.
The
great
disrespect.
Job by him.
The disrespect.
But again, maybe a little too early here, Blazing, the down 1-0.
But you know what? You know, if you're going to play like that, my thing is, if you're going to have some BM, right, be consistent with it. Don't do it when you're winning or you're losing. And Ghost, they're down one round, but if you're going to play like that all game, because if not, it's going to affect what your team's been on. They're like, oh, you was talking all that trash beforehand. Where is it at now? But we know Rushy's going to be consistent with it. Now Echo Fox pushing up top. Toy will strike first. Sleepy trying to even the odds. And once again, Sleepy gets a big double kill.
Yeah, I mean, look at the scoreboard, though. 158 to 156. Big double kill coming out there. Now we're on board with Solar's here. Two players in this site's bearing down upon them. One's going to head to Winch. Ribs going to rotate around here. Fight going down at B.
That's a key fight, too, at B as well.
It's a fight for the round, potentially, Blaze, as we're going to see a one hill each. And now B going the way of Ghost Gaming. Solar's trying to contest, but gets pushed up on by Speedy, looking for the double. Now bouncing around Ribs. Speedy shutting him down. Ghost Gaming coming back with the answer here in round number two.
All right, let's see. You're going to see it's ticking up. Ghost Gaming has two hills. Now they just have one. Echo Fox is going to have to get that B hill decap. They're going to have to get that A hill capped as well. But Ghost is going to have their home hill. This should be a Ghost Gaming round. I don't see Echo Fox doing anything to stop that. And yes, it will. They will even the odds up 1-1.
Yeah, great job there. 1-1 apiece here. Getting up, getting hype. And for those of you watching here wondering what's going on with Optic Gaming, they're currently in loser bracket, Blaze. They're playing Mind Freak 5-5 on Foundation first
and
map.
And they were down 5-3 as well. So they've started to come back. But Optic, whatever's going on with them, they're going to have to, you know, get back to their top tier form. We haven't seen them lose as much. But when you start winning as consistently as they are, then sometimes you're going to start to fall by the wayside. It's hard to be that consistent and be that dominant in any game. And this is going to be an event that really tests them.
And we've never seen them in losers this early. They're playing for top eight right now versus Mind Freak. Just going to go ahead. Optic even took a 6-5 advantage over them in map number one.
And so even speaking of that, and so we're going to have the Marshes go down. That's going to be a good placement for Echo Fox. But so the loser of this match goes into the loser's bracket side of Optic Gaming United. So three of our top four teams will be in loser's bracket, but two of those teams will not make top four. One of the teams will be
top. Wait, what? Say it again.
So two of our top four teams will not make top four.
Say it again.
Two of our top four teams won't make top four.
Vegas, man. Everything's bigger here.
And so one team will get top eight, one team will get top six, and the other team will progress through. And, of course, one of these guys will make it towards our winner's finals. And we'll see what happens. But this event has been shaken up so far. And it's been a crazy one. But I'm happy.
Yeah, and for Ghost Gaming, I mean, this is their best opportunity. They got third. They got second. Now they have a chance to go into the winner's finals, put himself in a great spot to take this event home with a win over Fable. They already beat them in pool play. They want to continue going forward. Speedy looking to line up some shots from a distance here. Trying to get those picks, trying to get those marks, shoots another shot, misses two in a row. Not very common from him, but he will have some more opportunities here as he rotates around to his teammates on the bottom of that ramp.
Yeah, you're looking for a better angle. He was getting pushed out by Fran and Elm. Rushy's picks up a kill. Man advantage in favor of Ghost Gaming. Speedy going to try to see if he can connect with one of these. But Rushy's takes out Ribs. Two more goes down. Three goes down. Echo Fox gets control over Top Stern. Sleepy Time is in a position. He's trying to get some shots on him. But Sleepy should probably overextend Echo Fox's home hill. Maybe, but their team do have control over B, so he doesn't have to be too hectic with it. He just needs to try to see if he can pick up some kills, control top. He's waiting for some teammates to get there, but now he's going to have to fight a big 1v1 with Praise. And that was the thing. I almost thought he should have rotated a lot sooner, but he thought their team was very secure on top of that B hill. Now they got a big fight on top of their home hill.
Yeah, I agree. I almost said the same exact thing, Blaze. But right here, Ribs, Rushies, come up with a couple kills. Echo Fox pushing the pressure yet again, looking for that domination. Already have one-to-one score count here, Rushy. Trying to get the shots off, not going to get it. Echo Fox, a team kill from Braze, but a double kill. If you want to include that kill on Rushies. Now it's three for Braze. Don't give him four. Don't give him that disrespect.
He's going to get his health back, and he's going to get another kill as well. He's going to have to deal with his old teammate, Ribs. Ribs, can he win this engagement? Praise is on fire.
Oh,
he will
my
get
Lord.
A little cross from the other side of the map. Domination coming through. Praise is going to get some help from Toy as well. Rushy's trying to roll to the hill, but he can't get there.
Now, you might have went colorblind that round. Put the blinders on. My team, your team, anybody in my way, I'm going to destroy them.
And so if you know Praise, you know how hype he is. You know how passionate he is about this game. And he loves good matchups. Also, Echo Fox, they want their rematch against Fable.
Oh, Fable, you better believe
Fable
they
is
want
the team that eliminated them last event. And Praise, he wants blood. He wants revenge. They're waiting for him. And I kind of asked him, I said, hey, do you consider Fable like, you know, one of the top teams? You know, because Marsh and Krim is crazy. And he said, those names don't sound scary to me just yet. You know, they're still just Marsh and Krim. But he says, if they beat us this event, then he says, yeah, they're definitely going to be the real deal. And but that's kind of the mentality that you got to have. You know, you got to have some respect for your opponent, but also at the same time, you got to believe that you're still the best. And Praise definitely does, and he is the X factor for Echo Fox.
Yeah, any moment can go off like a monster. Again, though, Torque up top, so we didn't see Speedy do too much with the last round, Blaze, and that's going to be a big focal point here when you put that weapon down for him and know what he can do with it. You don't want to see him shooting those shots and missing and not getting those crucial kills. But here we are at the beginning of round number three. Players up top on Winch and on Stern, so who will make the first move? It's going to be Rushies pushing in. 1v1 on Winch. Speedy and Sleepy get their kills. Rushies gets his. Whoa. Ghost Gaming really quickly with four dead now for Echo Fox. They're going to try to apply that pressure, I believe, and force his cap.
This is a 1v1 Solus versus Idenis, and Idenis with the Botox. We know how deadly he is with that weapon. He loves it so much. And now the domination comes through, and Ghost Gaming ties it up 2-2. Oh, man. This is going to be a back-and-forth matchup because both these teams are very, very talented. And either one of these guys can win an event. You know what? I don't know if OpticGamer is going to win this one, folks. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to keep it real with y'all. We may have a new champion for this season. OpticGamer is going to have to go on an incredible run. And they just hit a 7-5 map against Mind Freak. Now, not to take anything against Mind Freak. They're the best team in Australia. But still, this is OpticGamer we're talking about.
This is the champs, yeah. And hope your seat is comfy because I'm pretty sure we're going to be in for a long one here with Ghost and Echo Fox going back and forth, 2-2. Potentially a three-map series, I want to predict if I'm going to go ahead and say it. I don't think anybody's winning 2-0 here.
That's going to be very, very difficult, and I agree. And if they do win 2-0, it's going to be like that 7-5, 7-6. We'll see what happens, though. But now, off the opening break, we're going to have three members pushing up. A 4v4 team fight between Winch and Stern. Fran was first to the fight. He got the quick pick, but he got up there so quick, and he's going to end up getting down. And you know what? He got down because of that mark, so you have to be careful. He thought he had a nice little smoke screen to get it, but wasn't able to.
Yeah, you got to be careful. Like you said, another kill from Sleepy there. We got marks on the map, Voltox on the map, so definitely weapons to contest here with those angles and that long distance. And just like that, it's going to be five dead for Echo Fox. Ghost Gaming going to take their lead here, 3-2 over Echo Fox, map number one.
All right, Ghost Gaming is coming out strong, keeping that energy up. Both teams know that this is going to be a dogfight. It's going to be a bloodbath. But what you know, what Ghost has been doing so well. They've just been rebounding. They've been slaying up and getting the kills in which need to be gotten. The good marks to play as well, able to get Fran down. He was able to capitalize with that and chain that together to a few kills. And especially with our top teams, when you get that opening down and when you have that man advantage, they usually translate those into dominations, especially with the higher response.
Sleepy time, 10 kills also for Rushies. Usually it's that speedy Rushies duo
and
there, but Sleepy.
Sleepy's event. Anybody goes back and watches the footage, you'll see that Sleepy has been playing out of his mind, and this is probably the best event I've ever seen him have. We'll see what they can do, though. Sleepy. On board with him. Gonna be up in there with the fight with Rushy. Torquo is still down, not picked up, but the Botox, the Mark, so they're gonna be picked up for both teams. Sleepy just pushing through the smoke, looking for the first kill, takes out Toy. Echo Fox on their back heels, but Praise responds, picking out Ribs. Fred comes in, he takes out Speedy. Now, they're looking to push in, trying to get Sleepy time as well, so Echo Fox in a prime position. Gonna get that revive. He said, where you going, Rushy's read him like a book. Torque Bow picked up as well.
Yeah, set the trap for him and fell right into it. So Echo Fox looking now to make it a 3-3 score. Going into halftime, back and forth we go. They're already on the home hill. Speedy and Ribs off respawn, but do they have enough time to touch here? One last chance. Ribs gets the roll in, but he will get chunked immediately. Echo Fox, one hill, two hill, three hills, 3-3, map number one.
Whew. Expected, though. You know, we expected these guys to kind of split it early on and go toe-to-toe with each other, but it comes down to who's taking those advantages. Who's making the kills? And Sleepy broke ice first early on, but the rest of the team was just able to respond, you know, with that defensive shotgun style. They're going to make sure they hit you with all those shots. If you're going to be rushing these guys, you got to think about what Echo Fox prepares for, right? They prepare for optic gaming 9 out of 10 times. Both these teams kind of do. Optic gaming is very, very aggressive, and both these teams usually match up differently with them. So Ghost kind of resembles optic gaming more. So with Echo Fox's preparation, it's going to work out for this Ghost Gaming squad, too, because Speedy's Rushies, you know, those guys like to fly at you, get in your face, and we know how methodical Echo Fox love to play. We know how they love to get those crosses in as well, so they're playing to their strengths. Being aggressive, but also slightly defensive as well, but we kind of heard Kyle in that interview saying that, hey, they're just trying to push, win their fights, and take their advantages as well.
Yeah, I mean, back in Mexico City, Echo Fox, you know, they did have that more of a passive style, we'll say, but they've been banging with the best of them the past couple weeks, went back to the old Echo Fox, and been paying dividends for them. We've seen it online, now we're seeing it here on land. 3-2, winner semifinals. Fable waiting in the wings, which I still cannot get over Blaze. I'm starting to harp on it over and over again, but we're never in this position here of a European team waiting
in the
wings here.
Placement. They, you know, they tied the highest placement of a European team last event before, and now they broke that with top three as well, also being the first team to make it to a winner's finals. Fable definitely making history, but they're only two games away from winning the Vegas Open.
Yep, on board with Fran here. Fran doesn't see him spotted out there in the smoke, bouncing around, trying to get the shot up, but Rushies took three to kill him. Still got the job done, though. Toy Soldier going to return the kill on Speedy, so trading out some kills here on top now with Toy Soldier back on board with him. Cross coming out, 2v1 potentially coming in as they're pushing around the E-Hill. Not capped out just yet, Blaze, but and believe me, they're not leaving this fight just yet.
Just look at his movement. You know, it's so hard to do what Toy is doing, but he's getting close, taking shots, but he's also bouncing back into a defensive position, especially while he was in that 1v2, waiting for his teammates to kind of regroup with him. And now domination is coming through. Can Idenis make it to the neutral hill in time? He's going to fall. I don't think anybody's going to be close enough to the home hill. Not from what I'm seeing. Maybe not able to.
He got in there, man. He got in the last second. He got in there. But here comes Praise around the corner. Up East gets the kill, looking again for another multi-kill, but shut down beautifully there by Ghost Gaming, recognizing their distance. Not wanting to get in his face, realizing Praise is the threat on the map right now.
Now, so these are going to be 10-second respawns, so we're going to have a lot more action in this round compared to the previous round where it was 20-second respawns. So your life, you can kind of be a little bit more riskier, but you know, you have to still be smart with the Deluxe. But Fran, he's going to be the first on the defense, trying to get some good shots in on Ribs and Idenis as well. He has his teammates behind him, looking for a little bit more help. He's full red. He's going to rotate out of there and try to play his life, but they're trying to hunt him down, and he's going to regroup with the squad. Echo Fox. Might get up.
I thought he was going to rope it open just now. I thought he was going to rope him in there to winch, but not to be. Solar's up top, gets the kill. Two hills to one for Ghost Gaming. Now they're down a little bit in points, but they will come back off a two-hill cap here. Maybe a little too early, I think, with that, though.
It's very close. They're only down by 10 points, and also right now, Echo Fox doesn't get any points. They decapped that E-hill, so folks, it is first to 210. So now, as they're racking up the score, you're going to have Praise get in here, at least try to regain control over his home hill. He knew he had a little bit more time, because they had like a slight 4-point lead, but just trying to back out. He had no help, and he was in a 1v2 situation, goes to play to smart. Still, one more guy trying to get in to contest, but at this point, Echo needs a domination. He needs to decap both home hills. Ghost Gaming is locking him down, and Ghost Gaming should go up 4-3 in this one.
Yep, 4-3. Ghost Gaming will go up. They're getting excited again. Please, the rematch, the grudge match. People say, you know, Echo Fox, they had a bad event in Mexico. Ghost thinks they're the real deal. This is the test here. Who will be our team to advance?
It really is going to be the test, Deluxe. And Ghost Gaming has such a phenomenal showing the last event. And I want to say, I think that was that Fatal's first event as his coach? Or was he their coach in Dallas as well?
I think he was in Dallas. I don't disrespect Fatal right now, but
yeah.
He was there probably.
Yeah, he probably was there. I think he was there as well.
We'll say he's there.
But we've seen Ghost Gaming, we've seen their performance just keep increasing and increasing, going from third, going from second, and now we'll see if they can win this event, getting better every single time. All right.
Yeah, he was in Dallas, by the way. He was.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Confirmed. With myself.
So, Echo, so this time they lost the first round and a half, and they got the first weapon placement. So, instead of Torque Bow, they choose to put a drop shot down. Now, that drop shot is going to be able to break a lot of setups, but most importantly, since you pick up the drop shot at the highest point of the map, you can really, you know, get a lot of these guys who are going to be hiding behind cover and take them out of a few angles. So I like the weapon placement. We'll see what Echo Fox can do with it. But this opening fight kind of being won by Echo, and that kill by Toy is going to solidify it. They should be able to pick up this drop shot without any problem. Now let's see what they can do with it.
Yeah, bringing it back there. I like the placement too, Blaze. I got to agree with that. Echo Fox getting the kill as well. So weapon control in their favor. They're down one round. Toy Soldier making the proper rotations here to get in position to get those kills. He'll use his height advantage. Use the angles. No, nothing just yet.
So they got the intel that Ghost was grouping up and they were trying to retake up top. So Toy, he brought the drop shot back on over.
Oh!
Got his third eye open. Able to see through that smoke and pick up that double. Nice plays by Toy. Perfect map awareness. Looking for the next one. He's going to catch Speedy as well. Now Echo Fox looking to turn this into domination. Idenis is the last man up. But now you see Sleepies and Rushies. They're coming. Toy saw him coming from the way. From the wayside, looking for one. He gets two as well, looking for the third. Can Riv stop anything? I don't think so. Echo Fox ties it up 4-4.
Yep, shut. No, but not just yet. Hold the phone, ladies and gentlemen.
There's
we have
more.
An incoming alert here.
Rushies. He got something to say about that one.
Proper
decapping
rotation.
That E-Hill in proper time. We'll see if Ghost Gaming can turn this round back in their favor. But they need to get their home hill, and Sleep is going to be on top of it. Regroup with Identis. They should be able to get in there without any problem. Kyle and Solaris is waiting for him down the stairs. They're at a bad angle, and Sleepy's getting aggressive, trying to catch one of these guys while they get their Lancer out.
You know, they can cross them out here too as well, Blaze. I mean, they're kind of waiting for their shotguns out, trying to push down, catch them off guard, but it's Echo Fox keeping them at bay here, and they're still pushing up Solaris, Toy Soldier, and now a rotation from a third member, Echo Fox. They got him pinned in their home hill. Let's see if Ghost can get some kills. The first kill does come from Identis. One from Solaris, one from Fran as well. So 2-for-1, two players dead from Ghost Gaming. Only one for Echo Fox. And look at the lead, Blaze. Echo Fox 175 to 93. They don't got to do anything crazy. The only thing you got to do here is stay alive pretty much. You'll be good to go.
Rush is going to drop the smoke, try to stun some of these guys as he pushes through, but he's going to go down. Two hill advantage in favor of Echo Fox. They're only 17 points away from taking this round and finally solidifying this one. We thought they had it earlier, but this hill will be decapped, and nobody else is going to be in position to decap the rest of them. So Echo Fox does finally lock this round in on the board and tie it up 4-4.
Now, what are they going to put down to maybe on the other side of the map? You know, we've drop shot at the top. I think they're trying to maybe counter with something, or maybe put doubles down and do a marks again for Kyle, possibly.
Well, you know, I think maybe they're going to get the Botox down, fight Dennis. Maybe they do put the marks down again. But let's see. It's either be Botox down low or long-range weapon up here. Maybe Hammer Burst? Okay, yeah.
You got one, too.
Exactly. Given the Identis back the Botox on this one, I'm not curious about what – I'm not sure about – well, Echo Fox will definitely put the marks back down on those dual spots if they that's closer towards the drop shot if they do lose another round. But I'm not sure what Ghost Gaming will put in that spot. Maybe it might be a Hammer Burst.
Potentially, yeah. We saw Solaris pick up the Botox last time for his team. You know, no offense to him, of course, he's a great player, but Identis,
he
the best
him.
In the game.
Yeah, he really did outshot him in that one.
For sure. Again, Solaris versus Identis.
Get two shots in and just push him. But Fran will walk away with his drop shot in this engagement.
Yep, numbers up top. Ghost Gaming trying to push down to get the kills here, but again, Fran with that drop shot coming in, not going to connect though. Speedy's still alive, doesn't need, however, as Kyle gets two kills, and now Fran just uses him as bait to pick up that third. Ghost Gaming going to fall in numbers here. Echo Fox looking for yet another kill from Franchise. Ooh. Moving around, getting the gears one strafe.
The two oldest players on both these teams fighting each other out. Been in the scene for a while, and Fran's going to outclass Sleepy in that engagement. So the neutral hill being capped up for Echo Fox. Fran has one drop shot in the chamber. The question is, when does he use it? He's going to use it on those guys that may have flanked him, and he's going to take his right hand advantage to fight Rushies, and he's going to take him out in that engagement. I like the play. He's going to stay aggressive and take out Speedy as well. The old man pushing through. He's still young, but he's old in my eyes. He's been playing since I started playing.
And now looking for another. He's got teammates to support him. Franchise really, and I got to say, we know he's a great IGL. We know he's a great team leader. But over the past 2 weeks, I've been watching him. He's really stepped up in the slaying department, been getting more of these big, crucial kills, double kills. They get the round victory, and Franchise standing up, and rightfully so. Echo Fox, the crowd loves it. We love it as well. 5-4, Echo Fox.
Franchise making sure he hits those shots. Exactly what he did. So, okay, Echo Fox, they go up one round. We'll see how this ghost want to respond. I told you I wasn't sure. I said it may be Hammer Burst. Ooh, a block is a great option as well. Okay, they're going for the block. They saying, hey, this spot we usually don't utilize too much. We'd rather have all our guys pushed up, find a fight for the drop shot, trying to fight for winch control as well. As on the other side, Echo Fox, they can play the defensive style where they let Kyle use that marker and get those long range shots to help support the teammates and try to bait those gaming into picking up that drop shot. So I like the move by Ghost, you know, force Echo to play into their style.
Yeah. See what works out here again. Solars and Identitives do pick up Boltox in their hands. Smokes are going out. Players pushing through. Praise gets the first kill. He breaks ice for Echo Fox. Now Ribs caught out in a bad spot. All they gotta do is probably pistol him down there, potentially get it down, but not gonna do it just yet. Rushies with a return kill. Echo Fox versus Ghost Gaming, returning kills back and forth, and now it looks like Echo Fox might have enough momentum here, but Rushies shuts him down again. Back and forth, the kills are going. Blaze, nobody getting the advantage yet. Ribs with the drop shot, he snuck it out of there. The sneaky wise man comes up with a big play there. Now looking to use it. No go there.
Catch Praise, and Praise will get away, but they still have two drop shots to use, and they have a two hill advantage. Echo Fox still does not have their home hill, but they're gonna start to cap it up now. Ribs is looking, he knows exactly where it is. Catches him with the headshot, and that's good. That's why, you know, if you guys are trying to compete, make sure you're always marking players. Even though, you know, they couldn't see him, that player was probably marked, so Ribs knew exactly where he was on the map in that attack comp.
Yeah, somehow Kyle got out, but actually got caught in the wall. They're not able to do it. Now a double kill. Ribs kills Rushies right after he gets that kill. Three players dead for Echo Fox now. Here's an opportunity for potentially Ghost Gaming to overextend, but nope, they're gonna sit back and just wait. They got the advantage, they got the height advantage here, and the numbers game. So maybe a couple of months ago, maybe they would have pushed in there, Blaze, been over aggressive, but now they're playing a much smarter game, and
they are
definitely paying off for them.
They drop shots about a minute off, and both these teams know that. So that's why we're starting to see Echo get in position. They know that with the score count, they don't have to be too aggressive yet, but you want to time it perfectly where that you get in, you win a fight, and then you can also pick up drop shot as well. So the fight has started. The first kill has not went down just yet. A lot of smokes trying to find a player through him, and Rush is going to strike first. Praise is in a difficult spot. He's going to drop. But Fran coming in, trying to retaliate. He's going to have some help from Toy. Fran falls. Can Toy clutch up? He gets it down. Amishio, but he goes to the ground. Now drop shot will spawn up in about 25 seconds. Ghost Gaming will have that top hill control. They're going to have to use this drop shot. And pretty much they can use it defensively. You see the big lead in which they got. By the time Echo Fox has to push up there and contend for it again, they got three drop shots to work with. If Echo Fox wins this round, I'd be truly amazed.
Yeah, exactly the problem there. I mean, we saw four dead Solars, the last guy alive, and Ghost was just like, we'll sit here, put some more points, come push to us if you want. Got drop shot, got the angles. We have everything we need to win this round, make it a 5-5. If they lose it, though, I mean, a real, real heartbreaker. But Ribs with a kill. So far, Echo Fox not able to do anything just yet, and it looks like Ghost Gaming is getting enough kills required here to close this round out. They're on D, they have it. 207 hits. 5-5 here, Blaze. First map, and we are not surprised, but we're definitely excited for this one.
Yes, it is tied up. Both these teams trading off these rounds back and forth. But in that round, Ghost Gaming, they played it very, very smart. Once they started to build up that lead, they said, hey, you know, we can just play for this power weapon control. We know that these guys got to rush up the ramp. Just have your lances out, get ready for them, use these smokes defensively, and just pick them off one by one. And that's exactly what they did. So the blocks are used. These next two spots is probably going to be nade positions. We're going to get some frag grenades and incend grenades on right here mid-map and also docks as well. So looking like Echo Fox choosing. They say, hey, you know what, let's get these nades down mid-map. And I think that's what's going to go down. But this fight is going to be very important. Still, it's going to be coming down to the stern because, folks, we are approaching 18-second respawns, I want to say. So anybody who wins this team fight early on should come out with this domination.
Yep, and we see right there, frags go down. Kills are pretty even across the board there. Denim's a low man for his team, only 9, but everybody else in double digits. And Fran, yeah, you can say, look at that, man. 23
kills for his team. He's definitely going off. He wants to win this for his team. Stepping up. Fran wouldn't be considered the main slayer for the squad, but he is definitely showing up. All right, let's see what's about to go down. Rush, he's trying to play this winch. Nobody's going to contest him. He's going to get a smoke behind his opponents. That's going to stun them and mess up their vision as well. Nade's being picked up by Toy. We'll see what he wants to do with him. He's going to have to throw this one very, very precisely. If his teammate was getting marks, he's going to opt not to use him. I like it. Approach the fight with your lancer first. See what your teammates can do. He should get a double with that one. He gets one, but the drop shot will get picked up by Ribs. He's going to toss another one, trying to fight his flank as well. He's trapped in a difficult spot, and Toy, with his movement, will just try to slither away from this one.
Yeah, Toy doing a lot of work, but again, the hills go in favor of Ghost Gaming and the drop shot, so you have everything in your favor right now. Echo Fox has to push into you. You know where they're coming from. Just mark them out, get ready for the push, and use that drop shot when needed. Rushies, though, may not be the right guy with the drop shot. I'm not saying he can't use it properly, but he's so good with the shotgun and other weapons that maybe he wants to trade it off to somebody else. But
I agree with you. Yeah, he's gonna come up short with that one. Kyle's pushed up. He's trying to hold off. He cleans up the kill on Kyle. Gets some damage on Toy as well. Backing up, regrouping with his teammates. Getting the next drop shot. Reloaded. Didn't want to use it. Now he's second guessing himself. He puts it down and he's able to take out Praise. Now Toy trapped between three foxes and he managed to take out one and slither away. But he will hit the dirt. They will clean up that kill as well. It's still early on in this game, but you see Ghost Gaming winning all of these early engagements, but they're not able to turn them into dominations. They're not worried about it too much. We got less than a minute till the new drop shot comes up, and I think they're just going to hold off, wait for it, be patient, and this round is kind of shaping up like we saw the round beforehand.
Yeah, and again, to reiterate the point here, Ghost Gaming changing it up their style of what we normally see, playing a much more passive style. When they get those hills, they're holding them or not. Overextending for no reason, only when it's the proper time. I'm really impressed what they're doing here, but again, we're at 5-5, so any moment, any double kill, triple kill, push, four players pushing in for Echo Fox. Now this is the match, this is the fight of the match here. Rushies gets one, Rushies gets two, looking for it there, Rushies gets three, and Ghost Gaming has the advantage yet again up top. 5-5, but man, what a big play for Rushies.
Four members down for Echo Fox as well. We'll see what Ghost wants to do. Solar's just trying to hold it off, and that's a beautiful kill by Giddens because he gets this, and that's right. You overextend. You decap your opponent's home hill, and so that's going to have to stop what Echo Fox is trying to do. He's just going to try to decap this one and get cover.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter, Blaze. Same thing as last time. Solar's alive. I mean, he stays alive for himself there and his team, but the point lead is so big for Ghost Gaming here, they don't need to really worry about him. It's not a problem. They have all the hills here in control. Ghost Gaming 197. They have the kills. They have the hills. They're looking to go up here 6-5, and they will do just that here in our round number 11.
All right, folks, we're entering 20-second respawns. This next team fight's going to be crucial. And it's going to be one weapon slot available. That's going to be on the docks now. I think we're just going to get incense there, really nothing else. You know, you can ask Solars what he wants to fight for, and I'm pretty sure he's going to say incense, especially in that engagement with Idenis. No point in putting another big power weapon down there and drawing somebody else towards that direction. These rounds have been lost by just slight adjustments by both teams. That's why you don't want to do nothing crazy towards the late end, because you got each other figured out pretty much. It just comes down to who comes up with a great strategy and executes it.
Yeah, and again, Identity is still sitting on 9 kills, which means the entire round, as long as that was, did not pick up a kill that whole round. So for them to come back here and win 2 in a row, they're up a 6-5 here.
Yeah.
Like I said, no problem with Dennis, you're good to go.
All right, on board with Rushies. He's going to get the smoke behind his opponents. And that's one thing, Echo Fox is not contesting him on that witch. They don't want that fight, so they're allowing Rushies to come through. And you're going to see Fran get that kill on Ribs. Rushies going to have to deal with Toy as well. Toy's going to get the shotty out. Rushies taking some damage, and Toy falls in that engagement. Rushies finding a way to come out on top with that one. Sadiqi gets caught trying to run away, and now Praise left in a 1v2. He's going to get some damage in, and he's going to actually have help in. Coming in late, Fran gets one. Can the team leader get the last fight? Him versus Speedy. Fran gets that one as well. Locks down a home hill for the squad, and he's going to get the drop shot as well.
Big play, a double kill coming out there for the team of Echo Fox. They have drop shot, and now it's their turn. Take the advantage and use it to win this round. They have two hills. Fran wants to be a little more pushed up here than what we saw Ghost Gaming do. Maybe use those marks right now and get those free kills from your teammates. But maybe caught out here in a bad spot, Blaze, if he's not careful. And now he smartly recognizes that, move back up top with it. Ghost Gaming down here, triple cap coming out for Optic. Excuse me, Echo Fox. Franchise, that's going to be it. Echo Fox.
There we go. They tied up, folks. We're going to a round 13. And we wouldn't expect nothing else between these two guys, between these two squads. So let's see. So Ghost Gaming, I think they're going to remove the drop shot, and they probably put Torque Bow down once again because they have to change the weapon on the map. And, yep, they're going to scroll all the way through, and they're going to get their Torque Bow down. Drop shot has been very, very deadly so far, but Ghost Gaming has been getting a lot of good kills with it, but Echo Fox has been using it a little bit better. And, yep, so this is going to kind of stage up how we saw it in the first half, and I'm not sure who took the last round in the first half when the respawn timers were higher, but we are going to be in 22-second respawn, so if you do die, it's going to be a slim chance that you actually are able to have enough time to respawn and even have an impact on the next fight.
Yeah, and it might be the round might be won before the Torpo even comes into play. They might get enough kills up top to rotate probably from there. Here we go, round number 13, Echo Fox, Ghost Gaming. It's been a good one, and it's going to get even better going forward here. We're on board here with Rushy, looking to get that first kill on Winch. Two players from Echo Fox are rotating, so no kills going on. Just yet, we see a player down low, probably Toy Soldier down there mid. Playing for nades. So many big opportunities here, but nobody taking advantage just yet. Speedy does get Torque Bow, so if we can get on board with him and see what he can do here,
Rushy
maybe we'll have a chance.
Speedy knows it, and he's trying to put some shots, trying to see if he can clean up Praise, but Praise is staying aggressive, and he missed the Torque Bow by an inch and getting chased down, but that's going to give top control to Echo Fox, which is still good, because the thing is, Speedy, by him staying away, playing his life, he can kind of rotate down low with his teammates and try to play for both these home hills. Coming out with the power weapon is good, because it's going to extend Ghost's life once again. But both nades going in favor of Echo Fox. They have two incense and two nades to work with, and they're going to block off this pathway for Ghost Gaming to get to their home hill.
Yeah, and it's got to come out sooner or later. You got to get those Torpo kills. You got to get those marks from teammates. Looking for another shot there, and we don't see him miss this many shots very often. Blaze in a crucial moment to be missing in. Does turn around and get that kill on Fran, though, so still alive in this game. Echo Fox pushing up on Speedy, but Dentives now coming to the game, getting that 10th kill on the board, maybe 11. Solars with a kill, Dentives with a headshot on Toy. Back and forth to go, 4 dead for Echo Fox, only 2 for Ghost. Here's an opportunity now to push up.
Oh, and Solars will go down. Now Praise coming off a respawn. He needs to figure out which hill he needs to get to, and he's going to take the 1v1 versus Sleepy. I like the play. Get up there as soon as possible. Try to back him down. He's going to get his smoke out. Sleepy doesn't have help just yet, but they know the domination is coming through. So we're going to have 2 separate 1v1s being fought so the rest of the team can get there. But Idenis, he's not going to stay aggressive on this. He's playing a little bit passive, and he's going to actually fall down. Nope, he's still alive. Now he goes down. The pinch came in from Praise mid-map. So Echo Fox still able to control their home hill, and the score is still close.
Yeah, 119 and counting here. Very close round. Again, this is our round number 13. 130 and counting for Ghost Gaming, a 20-point lead over Echo Fox in a crucial first map. Sleepy's on top, playing their numbers up top here, Blaze. So once again, there'll be one final push here from Echo Fox to see if they can break it. And here come the smokes. Here comes the cavalry. Echo Fox coming in. Rushy's backing up. Sleepy supporting in the back. Pistol shots are good, but not going to get any downs just yet. The pressure coming in so furious from Echo Fox. They're going to trade kills, though, with Ghost. Any kill here at any moment could shift this round. Sleepy time backing out, though, not engaging in the fight, Blaze. Maybe a smart move for him as they're up 170 and 145.
Torque going to hand to Kyle. He's going to connect with Sleepy. Where you're running, Sleepy time. And now Kyle is going to get this advantage. He's going to get the height advantage. Looking across towards the home hill, trying to see if he. Whose man's is this?
Ladies
taking out Speedy on that one. Looking for the next kill. But Ghost has the lead. Echo Fox needs to get some of these decaps. Kyle versus Ribs. Is he able to get Ribs to win that engagement? And they're going to lock down that E-Hill for Ghost Gaming. Kyle just could not get it through Ghost. They need to hold this hill, but they're getting pressure. Fran is trying to join. He needs to get on top of this hill before 207 hits. Can he do it?
Touches it. Is he in time? I'm not sure
if
he's in time or not.
I don't know.
But they got FSGB Ghost Gaming taking the victory. They cap the FL out. They get the victory 7-6 in map number 1. A nail biter plays down to the last second. What an amazing map number 1.
As we said, this was going to go down to the wire. And folks, that's as close as it can get. Echo Fox versus Ghost Gaming. Ghost Gaming takes map number 1.
That was one hell of a map. But you know what, Waldo? It was pretty simple what this all came down to. If you win the Stern, it decided the map. By winning Stern, you get complete map control. And what Ghost Gaming did right there, they outnumbered it and they outpowered Echo Fox. And by doing that, they were able to get the power weapon, which was a drop shot at the time, and towards the end, the Torque Bow. What we need to see from Echo Fox is more aggression towards those power weapons, because once players like Franchise got a hold of that, he got 6 kills straight, 2 with the drop shot. So they need to capitalize on those power weapons.
They do, but I think that the reason that they ended up losing is they got hesitant in the middle of the rounds when they had the drop shot down. Instead of pushing up there and taking control, they lost track of Ribs that one round. He stole the drop shot, he backed out, gave them the advantage, and then all of a sudden, Ghosts are back in control.
Yes.
Echo Fox was not strangleholding the leads they had, and they were losing track of players. And when you start doing that, it allows them to come back into the rounds that you should be taking and winning.
Well, there were missed opportunities on both ends, but mostly on Echo Fox. There was one round in particular where Stern was won by Ghost Gaming. There was two players forcing that fight with Echo Fox while Toy Soldier went on the flank. Toy was unable to capitalize on that. He was in a pretty hard situation, but if you're there in that position, you're going to have to put it all on the line to make sure your team wins that power weapon and that hill.
You really do. And in that last round, Kyle got some nice headshots, but he had to take the 1v1 with Ribs a little bit quicker, but wasn't able to do it. And Fran, he almost made the play for his team. And you know what? So far, you know, these guys, Ghost Gaming, you know what? They edged them out 7-6, and that's a close one. You got to love it.
Yes, congratulations to Ghost Gaming, and we'll go to Map 2 on Foundation after this short video.
I'm Fatal Strike, head coach and lead analyst for Ghost Gaming. I think the coach role is extremely important. If someone misses a call out, I could try to help them by making that call out. If a weapon I know is going to spawn soon, helping them figure out which weapon's the one we need to play for. Part of being a vocal coach is just getting the team hyped up, getting them on the same page, and making sure that we know exactly what our objective is. For us, I think the key for victory is making sure we operate at a medium and a high, and not a low and a high. Our defense needs to be on point. Our lane coverage needs to be on point. Communication is a big deal for us. We've been working on that. If a team is going against Ghost, what they can expect is pressure, trash talk, and efficiency. We have some tricks up our sleeves this event, that's for sure.
Fatal Strike has been amazing for this Ghost Gaming roster. He's been in the game for about 10 years now, so the knowledge that he brings to the game and how he calms his team down, I mean, this is a new Ghost Gaming that we see. They're playing as a team now. They're not just individual slayers, and that's pretty big, especially on upcoming maps like Foundation.
You know, I will say this. You know, we got a few talented coaches in the league, but two of my favorites have to be Fatal Strike and Affinity. One, because of their playing knowledge and kind of the impact that they've had on their team so far. And you cannot, you know, I don't care about the haters, but you cannot deny the impact that Fatal Strike has had on this Ghost Gaming roster. And he is a little bit more vocal than everybody else, but he brings the energy to this team, and he does what he needs to do. And I love it. He really is the sixth man of the squad.
With Ghost Gaming up 1-0 in maps, they're trying to make this a sweep with the 2-0 on Foundation. Let's kick this off with Echo Fox against Ghost Gaming.
All right, here we are on Foundation. A staple in Gears of War competitive since day number one. Both these teams are very familiar with the map, as we all are at home. Toy Soldier and Criticile for 2 kills for Echo Fox, 1 for Ghost Gaming right now. So Echo winning the initial fight here, Blaze, but again, early respawns, plenty of time. Speedy with a double kill. Great job by him. Looking for a third, but crossed out there by Echo Fox. Teammate in support, could be Identives. Shuts down one, looking for two now, but not going to get just yet. Graze coming in there, playing for his life.
Yeah, you got Ghost Gaming. Speedy came through very, very quick. You know, you just kind of put on a clinic early on, got those two early kills. Ghost Gaming trying to get the B hill in their home hill, capped up a little bit, but Identis will go down. Echo Fox pushing through. Kyle and Fran getting some big kills, and we'll see what Echo Fox is going to do with this one. One thing I love about Foundation is that you have many different strats in this map. You can play for the neutral hill and your home hill in a two setup, or you can play for both your home hills. Now, so we do know when it's halftime, the hills flip. So on some maps, you can't have two different types of setups. Well, for Foundation, you have various different things than what you can do on each side of the map. And so that's why I love it. It comes down to the rotations and how well you rotate after you lose a team fight, because there's always an opportunity. There's always an opening to extend around on this map.
Yeah, indeed there is. And like you just said, there are A and C in control of Echo Fox, now B for Ghost Gaming, who are seeing a 2-1 haircut advantage.
You saw them. They lost the initial fight at B, and their initial rotation was, hey, push top tables and go across and just control both homes, and let's give up the B hill to Ghost, and let's see what their next move is going to be. And we see top teams just keep constantly making those rotations until they get the kills that they need consecutively. That was a fluke. He reached over the counter trying to grab the cash and didn't get the kill first. Got to clean those up. But he goes down, and that was a beautiful flank, so Ghost Gaming is going to be able to lock that one, that neutral hill in, and hold that two cap. Let's see what they can do next.
And Ghost Gaming almost getting double up here in points by Echo Fox here on her first round. Plenty of time to come back. They have the hills, they have the kills, and now let's see what they can do with it. Gonna go on board here with Solars though. Echo Fox up top here. They want to play, it looks like, here for that top table fight. Ribs pushed out wide. Might get crossed down here by Echo Fox. He's not careful, and that's exactly what's happening right now. Ribs gonna go down. Teamy in the back though, gonna get the revive and try to get out of dodge here. They don't want to die in this situation. They're gonna back up a little bit, play more passive. Echo Fox as well has to be careful to not get slayed out on the home hill of Ghost Gaming right now.
All right, let's see. Ooh, Praise got the team kill. He's gonna fall as well. That's four down for Echo Fox. Ghost Gaming decapping a home hill. Toy falls as well. They just need to see Hill to strike in round number one. I don't think anybody's gonna be able to get there in time. Speedy's waiting for him. He's gonna be the first line of defense, and nope, they can't do it. You got Ghost Gaming taking round number one, but this weapon placement is going to be crucial.
Yeah, and with these two teams that we're seeing here, Blaze, I mean, they're so evenly matched at times. You give them an inch, they'll take a yard. You know, the opportunity, a door open for Ghost Gaming at the end of the round there. They picked up the kills, and they pushed forward, and they got the round win.
I'm expecting a block somewhere or the media boom placement mid-map. We'll see what they want to do. Ooh, Echo Fox. Now, we saw this a little bit in Season 1 where they favored the drop shot a lot on this map, and we saw what they did at the map before, making sure they put the drop shot down on Harbor, but this time, so both these teams, we usually saw these engagements where they want to fight for these big power weapons in close. So I was trying to see if you want to get that in early to kind of set the tempo, but Ghost Gaming as well, you know, they love fighting that fight as well. And I think Echo may have done their homework on that one. They're going to keep this fight closer towards Pistons. We are going to get a big power weapon somewhere. We'll see what goes down, but the instant placements will have a big factor in this game as well.
All right, here we go on board again. Our next round, we're going to go see some Solars action here as he's in open. He's always in the open. He's in that fight every single round on Foundation, looking to stay alive here as Fran does pick up a kill off screen. Identity of the trade. Fran with a double now. Speedy looking to contest here with the incense. He's going to toss one out. Blocks him some escape paths here, but not going to get the kill just yet. Praise still wants to get in his face and potentially fight this 1v1. Speedy versus Praise. It's a good one, too. Either way, it could go.
And Praise knows he has some help, but the flank coming in from Identity, and they're going to push him back a little bit. But they may have Sleepy wrapped back around on them, so they're going to have to be careful on that one. Looking to push through. They're going to get a stun by a smoke. Praise able to escape. And that damage he took was from Speedy rotating back around to kind of get some shots in their back. But Echo Fox pushing through the B-Hill. Praise is trying to catch somebody while they're lancering and pistoling with those support weapons out. Has one down. Ooh, he's stunned. And he gets the meat shield, and he gets help as well.
Yeah, Toy coming out with some support there. Great job by him. Great crucial kills, but here's Rushy. Did he know where he's at? He does this so often, the secret manning. He gets the one kill there, looking for the double on Toy. 1v1, the first shot from Toy, though, is so damaging, he cannot do a thing there. Toy going to cap that B-hill out, so no cap just yet for Ghost Gaming, but already a gigantic lead here, 78-18, so plenty of time left, but for Ghost Gaming, a great, great start.
That was a great team fight, 2v2 by Kyle and Fran on top of their home hill for them to get that overextension top tables. They have control over B. Ribs is down here by himself. He's trapped between Echo Fox Sandwich, and he's going to fall. So Echo Fox trying to get the domination. Sleepy's trying to clutch up on his B-Hill. He gets one down. He knows he just needs to roll in and decap before he cleans up this kill. He's going to take out Solars and now regain control over the B-Hill for his team. Fran is trying to push through as soon as possible, trying to secure this round for his team because he knows everybody else is trying to come off respawn. Big 1v1s, and Fran is going to win this one. Question is, will the domination go through? And it looks like the members of Ghost is pushing through, and they will get control of their home hill, and nobody from Echo Fox is going to be up to contest that one.
Yeah, just enough time delayed there on that B hill, allowing Ghost Gaming to get their home hill back yet again, and the score is a little bit closer now. We're almost at an even score here, but let's see who makes these rotations now. We have the B hill currently in place of Echo Fox, two hills to one for Echo Fox. Nice job by Solars there, turning and burning down Identity with that Lancer. Now recognizing a player up top in that suicide area in this little pit area here.
I want to see the overhead map. We'll see where they're stacking, but it looks like the stack is coming in through Cave and Echo trying to push through. They had Rushies kind of get down there and try to cause some trouble, but he didn't have enough help. But what has happened? I'm trying to figure out where the rest of his teammates are, and they're coming late to the fight. Okay, there we go. Most of them kind of pushing towards top tables on that one, trying to get to the home hill. That's a big kill by Sleepy. Now he's going to force Fran out. We'll see if Fran wants to fight that one again. And I think Fran says, you know what, most importantly, let me just try to get my home hill so my teammates off respawn can do something. But he's going to fall in that engagement. Now up to Praise, up to Toy. What can they do? Trying to stay alive. Identity gets one. Can he get two? Oh, not yet. And he's going to fall on that one. So Echo Fox does get the, oh, I spoke too soon. Speedy gets through, and they're going to cap that hill, and Ghost Gaming is going to take round number two.
And for the second time, Blaze, in two rounds, Ghost Gaming, you give them that opening, and they take it. They take it there. An untimely team kill from Echo Fox definitely did not help their case. But 2-0, Ghost Gaming already up one map. The pressure's on Echo Fox now in our semifinal matchup here. And look what goes down. What's going to go down here, Blaze?
You know what? All I know is that you don't want to go to the loser's bracket because that's one of the toughest loser's brackets we've ever seen. The toughest loser's bracket that we've ever seen in Gears Esports history. You got the defending champions. You got E United. And next thing you know, one of these two teams will be all on the same side of the bracket. We're going to have like so many little mini finals throughout the loser's bracket. Hopefully tomorrow we can catch all of that action.
I mean, every game tomorrow is a crazy matchup.
Really
every single one is
folks, you're gonna want to tune in early because it's gonna be a crazy, crazy day.
Make sure I get my my cough drops and whatever I gotta do. Make sure my voice is ready to go because we'll be yelling a lot.
I got you. I got my little mobile caster kit. We got Halls. We got Chloroseptic.
All right, man.
We
respect to that.
We got it all.
But do we have something for Echo Fox
Ghost
right now?
Ghost Gaming got all the kills in that round, and they're gonna steal the deal on round number three as well.
3-0, Ghost Gaming very, very quickly this time. They did not wait to strike till the end. They come out big early on here. Echo Fox, they're a composed team. You know, not gonna get down themselves, but man, 3-0, the way Ghost is playing right now, definitely a big uphill battle coming up.
All right, so we saw the block.
It's time now, Blaze.
It's time. We're already three rounds in, and I believe with these top teams, they know the boom shot's going down eventually. You might as well put it down early. I think when it comes down to a top four team, any team, that big power weapon needs to go down within the first two rounds.
Yep, and we're seeing it right here, boom shot down. Echo Fox, there's three rounds left they can win in a row here and make it 3-3 at halftime, which is their goal.
You know what, it's not unheard of. So with the respawn timers being 16 plus seconds, as long as Echo wins their opening engagements, they can easily tie this up 3-3. So don't count them out just yet, folks. But Ghost Gaming will have the man advantage by two, by three, and that's four down for Echo Fox. And boom shot and incense in favor of Ghost Gaming. Toys just trying to stay alive, extend the round, and I think he just needs to push all the way across.
It's trapped, though. I don't think he's going to get out of it. Toy Soldier, between a rock and a hard place, he will fall. Ghost Gaming, let's see if they're going to apply enough pressure now. Kyle going to be off respawn, so is Praise. Tossing out the smoke, but incense are on the ground, burning already. Nice dodge by Praise, but you can't dodge the boom shot. It's going to be Ghost Gaming, four in a row. A pressure applied and done very well for them.
I don't know if he could have, but Toy probably. He just needed to realize that Ghost Gaming's home hill wasn't going to get capped right away. He probably could have pushed through Statue and pushed all the way across and tried to fight a 1v1 on Ghost home hill. It would have been a slim opportunity. And right there, he didn't have many options in that one. He probably still would have died anyway, but he probably could have went for that overextension. But anyway, Ghost Gaming took the most out of that round. Now Echo Fox just needs to go into the half 4-2. They'll be a lot more comfortable than going into the half, you know, 5-1 or 6-0.
Man, I know it was in a losing effort, but the way Praise dodged that incident, by the way, Matrix-like. So
yeah.
I like to see that play from him. But
you know, he's playing a different game, folks. I'm convinced of it. He sees things differently than we can. So Praise, he's just that top player. But you see Echo Fox gets three kills in succession. They should be able to turn this round into a domination. Just need to get the scrap kills. You're going to have Idenas run away. They also fighting the fight on the home hill. That boom shot needs to get mobile. He needs to get to the spawn of Ghost Gaming so they can try to lock this one in. But Echo Fox also needs their home hill. The question is, who's going to get there in time? Now Ghost, can they make it in the hill? Solars gets a boom shot kill. Speedy goes down as well. Echo Fox should get their first round on the board, and yes, they will.
Yeah, they were not going out that way, Blaze. We kind of knew that. 4-1, Echo Fox answering back. And some of the Echo Fox faithful here in attendance, definitely showing their support for this team. And for good reason, you know. Bunch of good guys, longtime players. Definitely a top team in Gears of War since we've been here.
You know, Echo Fox has been fighting for a win. So has Ghost, but Echo Fox has been just trying to get that next win. In Gears of War 4, there's only been two teams that won. That's Echo Fox, and that's Optic Gaming. And Echo Fox is trying to get their second on the board. And this is the best opportunity. Best opportunity for both these teams because nobody would expect it. Optic Gaming to go out so early. And that's the team that both these guys were, you know, kind of scared of in a sense and preparing for the most. So the door is wide open for us to have a new champion in UGC Vegas. We'll see what can happen. Ghost Gaming strikes first. They strike twice. That's a double kill by Sleepy Time. They're looking for a third. Can Echo Fox retaliate in this one? Rushies is looking for that next kill, and that's going to be two more kills all up to Solars to try to stay alive, and he tried to get in for the flank. He's taking a lot of damage. He's going to fall as well. We'll see if Ghost Gaming can go up 5-1. This is a 20-second respawn round, and Toy is going to be next off of respawn. Smokes are going to be out looking for the fiber. Rushies trying to dodge, trying to decap the hill. He gets some help, but Rushies will fall. But Praise is going to save the round for his team.
He's going to fall as well, but great job by Toy, just wasting some time. Identity's on the hill. Boom shots there as well. Four dead for Echo Fox. One last attempt here coming off respawn, but not going to be.
Ooh,
as Ghost Gaming is shutting it down.
It's hot in here.
It's a pressure cooker. It's a fire fest. It is going to be Ghost Gaming going up 5-1 here on the first half. Unbelievable plays. You see them getting hyped. They're excited. This could potentially be a 2-0 here. A 7-1 if two more rounds are won in a row.
Ghost Gaming are two rounds away from meeting Fable in a winner's bracket finals, where they beat them already in pool play, which was our most exciting game on Friday. And I know Fable saying, hey, y'all beat us beforehand, but we got something for
one
y'all
now. One round game that was.
It really
seven,
was.
7-6 third map. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves here, though. We're not counting Echo Fox out.
We're not. Echo, but they got to do something special. They got to do something special.
They got
to change
it up.
They're going to have to tighten it up. And all right. So, pushing. Rushies is actually going to strike first, and he's going to get the double kill as well. This is going to be a 10-second respawn, folks, so these guys should be able to spawn up quick. But Ghost Gaming getting four kills in succession. Kyle left on defense. Rushy sees Toy coming off a respawn. They're just trying to see if they can take care of Kyle first. He's going to turn around and assist his teammates. They're going to trade off on those kills. Solars, what can you do? Smoke coming over the top. Solars falls!
Shut down.
And Ghost Gaming is at match point.
Yeah, the respawns were quick, but their rotation from Ghost was even quicker. Looking to have a dominant performance, Blaze, if they win this 7-1 right now. Something we could not have predicted. We thought it would go with three maps, but Ghost Gaming, unless they're able to, you know, squander this huge lead, are looking good for our winner finals.
We haven't seen.
Now, do you want to go on the record here with some? You made a bold prediction one time with Echo Fox versus Optic. Do you want to maybe throw something out there? You don't have to, of course.
What?
But
are you talking about them winning six rounds in a row?
Are you feeling
something in
the air?
And if you guys know me, my predictions, I'm pretty sure some Echo Fox fans are out there saying, Blaze, just say it, so give us some hope, okay? Because usually what you say is law. Give us some hope. Tell us they can win six rounds in a row. But I'm sorry. I can't do it. I just can't. They're going to have to make me a believer in this one, and they're going to have to just do something special that we've never seen before. We'll see who can strike first in this round. Rushies gets the incense. Toy gets a kill, but Rushies has the hot hands. He's going to trap Solars in a pressure cooker, but he makes it out. And now they even the odds. That's actually going to be two members down of Ghost Gaming. We'll see what Echo Fox can do. 12-second response.
Yeah, nice job there. Nice initial by Echo Fox. That's what you needed. Starts with the initial, then goes from there. Echo Fox looking to take it one round at a time here. On board with Kyle, gets the headshot. Nice shot by him. They're going to try to pinch out Ribs here down in the former B Hill. Now we're on D, E, and F Hills. They know he's on that U. They're going to push around. Nice team fire there. Nice down. Speedy with a kill off screen. So Echo Fox getting the numbers in their advantage here. Blaze early. It's exactly what they needed.
They need to take this one round at a time. One round at a time. They don't want to go to that devastating side of the loser's bracket, where they'll have to meet the bane of their existence, Optic Gaming. All right, so both teams, you got two members down from Ghost Gaming. Echo Fox trying to get control over their home hill. Solars did not see Ribs flying out of nowhere, but they do pick up that kill, and they're still holding a two cap.
Got that.
So no big power weapons on the map just yet.
Yeah.
They're gonna have to win this with their stock weapons, and I mean lancers, pistols, shotguns. Ghost Gaming looking for that next rotation. They have the E-Hill lock. At this point, both teams should be just making sure all players have respawned up. This is the time where you kind of come up with a strategy how you want to break this hill, because it's still early on. Just one team broke 100 points. You got plenty of time to develop a strategy in this one. And Ghost Gaming trying to regain control over their home hill now.
Yeah, building on the lead, that was Echo Fox. Rushies does get one kill there, but they're going to need to string together a couple more. But I like their numbers here, Blaze. 3v2 versus Echo Fox on the home hill. I'm not quite sure what Echo Fox was doing there. They are on the home hill, it looks like, on the other side, but you know, they're going to relinquish that control. Ghost Gaming is going to have now three dead for Echo Fox, only two for Ghost Gaming. Could be their chance to push through here and get this advantage back in their favor.
So Ghost Gaming can win off a two cap, so that means that Echo Fox is going to have to get mobile soon. But Fran, he's going to decap this E-Hill, and nobody's going to be contesting him, so that's actually very good. That means that Echo Fox is going to keep securing the lead in this round until Ghost Gaming can do something about it. Speedy has the incense, but he just blocked himself off, and Echo Fox is just leaving him there. Like, all right, I dare you to come down. I dare you to come down. He has one incense left in hand, not able to do nothing with it just yet. Still alive, though. Now he's going to be pushing out, but Toy is just going to be looking for an angle, try to get him caught out. He know that he's trying to make it to the E-Hill, and in that same process, Fran, I think he picked up a double kill on top of his home hill. Echo Fox can win off of one.
Yeah, and that should about seal it. You know, the only way that you can lose if you're Echo Fox now is if you all kind of get wiped here. Not going to happen. Toy wins his 1v over there on E, taking this opportunity to bounce around, get ready for next round. So Echo Fox, unless something happens like crazy here in the last couple seconds, which it won't, we'll get their second round on the board.
All right, Echo Fox fans, they put the second round up. They will take this one.
They win three, though, Blaze. I'm going to start thinking about it.
Yeah?
You know?
You will?
I'm going to start thinking about
I'm
heavily.
I'm slowly a believer, too. I'm with you.
I mean, just think about it real quick. This is an event we've seen Optic go to losers in the first round, right?
Yeah.
We've seen Ronin beat EU United.
Yeah.
We have all this crazy stuff going on. We're in Las Vegas. 6-2 right now. We've never seen a 6-1 comeback. I want to be that guy, of course. I'm not trying to reach here too far. But if it did happen, it would just go along with all the other crazy things we've seen.
It really would. And based off how crazy this event it has been, it really wouldn't be too much of a big surprise. We saw Ghost Gaming come back from a 6-3 comeback against Fable earlier. So, you know, we'll see what happens. Now, Rushies pushing down. Botox got placed. That's going to be a big weapon for Identis on top of those home hills for him to defend it. Now Rushies is looking to push across and kind of contest with Kyle. He knows that Kyle's focused on Identis. He's trying to catch him with his pants down, engage in a clean 1v1. Rushies wants it, but can he win the engagement? He catches Kyle with that one, and Kyle goes down. So Ghost Gaming should have a two-hill setup. Yes, they will. They will have F. They will have D. Toys is trying to push across the map and try to take the side and help Fran. Ooh, with the flank. He's going to shoot that one. He's going to get that down. Incens are coming out as well. Can't get the next one, but he's going to be in a prime spot just to push those guys back down.
Yeah, and there was heavy, heavy numbers pushed towards the home healer from Ghost Gaming, but they allowed their home healer to get capped behind them
that. They're on Ghost Gaming's home hill, so people can't spawn up behind them. So they're going to have to be very, very quick with this one. And somehow Rushies gets a big double kill across the map, and that's going to be four down, all up to Praise. And he's going to be on this E-Hill by himself, and he's going to wait to the last possible minute to cap up. Get some good early shots in on Rushies. He's going to have to push that one soon.
Rushy's trying to contest, so Praise does get the kill, but will he be able to pick up the cleanup on the ground? The triple cap's coming up. Praise full red, cannot get the touch.
Ghost Gaming looking
to close it out. In the last possible second, Echo Fox gets in there. Please, will it be enough?
They're keeping it alive, Fran, and he's full red. He's taking some damage, trying to stay alive, bouncing around, trying to get his health back, but Ghost Gaming ain't allowing it. Fran, he stops the domination from coming through. Kyle's the next man alive. I don't think he can make it, folks. Ghost Gaming goes to your winner bracket finals.
7-2, Ghost Gaming take it. They make us a believer. It was no fluke in Mexico. This is the top team to contend, and they're going to be playing Fable tomorrow in our winner's finals. What a great game.
Congratulations to Ghost Gaming. I mean, what more can you say? That was a pretty much a dominant performance. If you look at the end of Echo Fox, they had a bit of a lethargic performance in between the 5th and 7th round, somewhere around there. Only two players were in the double-digit kills. Ghost Gaming, everybody was going absolutely off. They're shooting off on all cylinders. Congratulations to Ghost as they go ahead and they go against Fable to get into the championship round.
That was a really good time. Listen, Ghost is shooting like I've never seen them before. They're actually playing really smart. They're hitting all of their crosses. They're allowing opportunities for Rushies to get in there and get the kills. It's not like the old Ghost Gaming style that we saw in previous events. They're playing very smart. They're playing very intelligent. Sleepy's picking up kills, and everybody is putting the throttle down and flying at all cylinders.
Yeah, we look back at season number one. Echo Fox had a stranglehold on that second place spot over Ghost Gaming. Ghost Gaming was a top three team, but now top two Mexico. They're in winners finals here. They're showing us their improvement over time. Their new coach, everything is working out for them so far, and it's a big opportunity here to maybe potentially win a championship.
I mean, this is pretty disappointing if you look at Echo Fox. I mean, after what we saw in Mexico compared to what happened now, I mean, let's just hope that they could actually, you know, keep a straight head and actually come back and compete in a loser's bracket. But I would like to send this off to the main stage for an interview with Ribs.